Just imagine if you could get your content seen by thousands of people simply through following a formula. Well, the good news is that I have come up with that formula. I've had pieces of content go so viral that they've been featured by Cosmopolitan, Women's Health, The Daily Mail, and the BBC. So I'm gonna be sharing a 7-step formula so that you can get your content going viral on demand. But first, it's important to understand what viral actually is. And a piece of content is defined as viral when it's circulated rapidly and wildly on the internet. But not just that, I also personally believe that something is classed as viral when it gets a significant amount of traffic, more so than normal. So let's just say you have 100 subscribers or 100 followers on Instagram. If your photo gets 1,000 likes, or if your video gets 10,000 views, that is viral relative to you. So I think here it's important to think of things in relative terms, because this formula is something that everybody can use to get significantly more eyes on your content than normal at the click of your fingers, and you can do it whenever you want. And you can do that thanks to my 7-step formula. Research, record, hype, post, promote, promote, and test. So if that is something that you are after, then make sure to smash that thumbs up. Let's dive into the 7 steps. And first, I think it's really important to understand why things go viral. Do you remember all those random quizzes that Facebook used to do that would tell you which Friends character you are? These quizzes went incredibly viral, and there are 2 reasons as to why. The first is based on emotions, and the second is based on shared human experience. So emotions, let's talk about them. Well, people take action due to feelings and not because of logic. The 3 feelings I have identified to be the most fundamental when it comes to getting your content to go viral are fear, shock, and laughter. And if you can elicit one of these 3 feelings in the people who are on the other end of the camera, then you are gonna have success. But the second component was that shared human experience. So people love to feel like they are part of something greater. So you need to figure out how to make sure that your content can make people feel like they're a part of a community. Let's look at this example of this video that I posted where I did a 10,000 calorie Reese's challenge. Let's take this friend and this friend. Well, if this friend shares the video with this friend because they both love Reese's, then that means that my video is helping these 2 people build a deeper level of connection and strengthen their friendship based upon their shared love of Reese's. So if you can be a part of helping 2 humans build a deeper level of connection, then you are going to win. Back to the Friends Facebook quiz. Well, let's just say your answer is Ross, and then you decide to share that all over your Facebook. Oh, haha, classic, of course I'm Ross. Then if that makes people laugh, then that means that you'll also feel like you're winning. You, the person who got Ross as your friend's character answer, then essentially look better in the eyes of all of your friends. So that means that you're more likely to share it. And then when your friend who saw that you shared the fact that you were Ross does the quiz and eventually finds out that they're Ross or they're Rachel, then they'll also share it, and they maybe even tag you to say, oh, haha, look at what I got. It's this part of this shared human experience with the comedy intertwined. So now that I've got that out of the way, it's time to get into the 7 steps. So step 1 is research. You need to do your research as to what goes viral within your niche. Now, if you don't already know what your niche is, be sure to check out this video, because finding your niche is fundamental, because otherwise, if you get a piece of viral content just for the sake of getting viral content, it is not targeted, it's not gonna help you grow, and people will watch your video but they won't actually end up hitting that subscribe, that follow, or anything else, and it won't provide any extra opportunities to you. So doing this without knowing your niche first is really honestly just pretty pointless. So your market research is key. So I'm gonna take the example of my Easter example again. I know that in my niche, which is actually helping people build their social media and dominate social media so they can build a wildly profitable online business. So if that's you, make sure to hit the subscribe. But I know that the majority of my ideal followers, ideal clients or whatever, they are people who are fitness coaches, health coaches, nutrition coaches, people who are interested in watching this type of video. They love to watch these cheat day videos. And I know that because I know that industry so incredibly well, having built a successful fitness coaching business in the past. So how can you figure out what does best for your niche? Well, what you can do is find 3 to 5 people who are in a position where you would like to be, who have good content, and see which photos and which videos get either a significant amount more likes, comments, or views. And then you can see, okay, these are the type of videos that do well, get a good understanding and a good feel for it, and then you know that that could be the type of video that you could create for yourself. Staying up to date with industry trends and news is also incredibly important, because then you can stay relevant. Now, I posted the Easter video video the day after Easter. So it was really relevant. People had just eaten a bunch of food on Easter Sunday. And if I could share this video of me eating loads of food, I would create a shared human experience so people would actually feel less guilty for all the food that they consumed over the Easter period. So now we move on to step two, which is actually recording your content. Now in this recording stage, you need to be really, really, really careful with how you show up. You need to think that this video is gonna go on top of Times Square. You are gonna be seen by thousands and thousands of people. Just imagine that. So you wanna make sure that you're positioning yourself in the way that you wanna be seen by the world. Now, I personally believe that you should always be doing this, but do this even more so than normal. Make the content high quality, make it engaging, and just make it, yeah, you being your true and authentic self. While you're creating the content, also remember that you need to have calls to action. You wanna make sure that you have conversion call to actions and engagement call to action. So an engagement call to action is something along the lines of hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe, because if everyone's watching this video, but no one's actually being told to subscribe, humans are less likely to take action unless you tell them to. So if you have not smashed that thumbs up, and if you haven't already hit subscribe, please be sure to do so, because if you're enjoying this video so far, I know that you're gonna like the rest of my content. Me saying that to you and telling you to hit subscribe means that you're more likely to actually stick around on my channel, because if you just watch a viral video and you don't hit that subscribe, then people may go on the video and they may just never be able to find you again. So you want to make sure that you're telling them to hit subscribe. And then you also need a conversion call to action as well, so that you can take people off of YouTube or off of Instagram and get them into your world so that you have them as a lead. So example, I have a free Instagram ebook that I'm giving away to you. All you need to do is click the very first link in the description box below. It's going to take you to Facebook Messenger. You have to click get started and then you'll get that totally for free. That is me taking you off of YouTube, taking you into my world, and now I have you as a contact on my Facebook Messenger bot, which means that I can send you messages as and when I choose to. But don't worry, I always give you really amazing free tips and I never spam. So that's what you need to do when you're actually creating the content. And then we move on to step three, which is hyping up your content and pre-promoting it. So what I did for the Easter video was this. I put it on my Instagram story telling people when it was gonna be going live. What you can also do is you can use the countdown timer on your Instagram stories. You can use the premiere function on YouTube. You can post it on your stories telling people what's coming. Maybe you could even create a small snippet of the video and post that on your story. You can tweet about it. You can post it up everywhere. You could even email your email list to tell them what's coming. Step four is to post the video. Now, when it comes to posting, there are things which are really important, such as the thumbnail, such as the headlines that you use. But I'm thinking that because they depend so much on each different platform, so for example, on Instagram is very different to how you would do it if you're doing it on YouTube. Make sure to comment below telling me whether you'd like me to tell you exactly how to go viral on Instagram or exactly how to go viral on YouTube, because I have experience with both and I can help you get content going viral on each, because this here, what I'm sharing with you right now, is the strategy, whereas telling you about how to go viral on Instagram, there are sneaky little tactics that you can do. Same thing goes when it comes to YouTube. So that is step four. If you'd like that, comment below. It's really, really helpful for me when you do comment, and also it supports the channel and helps me create even better and more value-packed content for you. So now let's move on to step five, promoting the content. You don't just wanna put the content out and just hope that eyeballs are gonna go on it. No, 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 no. You need to promote that content everywhere. You can email it out to your email list. You need to distribute it across all of your social media platforms. I like to use something called content splintering, where you take your original piece of content and you create other pieces of content based upon that piece of content. So for example, for the Easter video, what I did is I took the thumbnail, posted it on my Instagram story. I also could have made a mini video, posted it on my Instagram feed, 1 minute long or so. Could have created a 5 minute long or so snippet, put that on my Instagram TV. I posted it on LinkedIn as well. I could have also tweeted about it, posting it everywhere, making sure that you're getting as many eyeballs on the video as humanly possible. There are two other ways to distribute your content, which I think a lot of people don't typically think about. First things first is you can ask influencers to share it. Of course, when you're doing this, there needs to be a win for the influencer. Second thing to do is you can contact the media and tell them that you have a piece of content that would make a great story. What you should do is you should write the story for them, attach all the videos and photos, and send it to them via email. I personally don't believe that you should email just the random contact email on their website. What instead you should do is you should think, okay, what niche is this video in? For me, for example, the Easter video, that could have perhaps been a health and fitness one. So I could have found the health and fitness editor for, let's just say, Women's Health, Cosmopolitan magazine, something along those lines, showing, oh, this girl eats all this food,
She shares about how she doesn't truly believe that cheat days are even a thing and that you should have a good relationship with food or something, whatever, like whatever. But I would go on Twitter or LinkedIn to find the editor of the particular section of the magazine that I want to be featured in. That is a really good idea. Next up after that is promote again, because you want to promote the promotions. So if people are sharing it, if people are commenting, you want to take screenshots of these, you want to share them on your Instagram story to encourage more people to consume. The crazy thing about humans is, let's say a video has 50,000 views, people are more likely to watch it just because it already has views. It's just human psychology and human nature. I don't know about you, if I'm deciding between this video or this video, if this one has 100 views or if this one has 20,000 views, I'm gonna watch this one just because naturally I presume that this one is better just because it has more views. So if people are commenting on it saying what a great video, take a screenshot of that, share it on your Instagram story, circle the comments and all of that stuff. If the media features it, share that everywhere. You want to make sure that you're promoting the promotions. And then finally, we move on to step 7, which is test. You want to keep trying and testing different things. Make sure, by the way, to thumbs up this video if it has been helpful for you. You want to test things. You want to see what works. You want to make sure that you're trying things all the time. Because just because something doesn't go viral the first time, doesn't mean that it's not going to go viral the next time. Now, the thing is, when it comes to this type of content that's going viral, you need to make sure that you're ready for the virality. If you have no videos on your YouTube channel, but you just expect your very first video to go viral, for sure it may do, but people probably aren't gonna hit subscribe because they don't see that you already have a hub of content that is going to be valuable for them. Same thing goes on Instagram. You wanna make sure that you have consistently valuable content on your feed before you ever try and get something to go viral. I really do think that hopping on trends is a great way to go viral, great thing for you to do. If you are in the fitness industry, doing something like a 10,000 calorie challenge or a body transformation video, they do really well. You just want to make sure that you do them well, you put your own spin on things, and that you are your true authentic self, because otherwise it looks like you're just copying everybody else. I see so many people start YouTube channels just for the 10,000 calorie challenge video, and then no one ends up subscribing to their channel because they don't have any other valuable content there. So you want to make sure that all of your content is jam-packed with value, you put your own spin on it. Value can come in the form of education, entertainment, motivation, or inspiration. You want to do all these things. You want to make people feel a certain way. You want to make people feel like they are a part of a shared human experience, and get that shock, that awe, that laughter, that fear factor in there, and you are really gonna have success when it comes to going viral on YouTube. So next video, if you like it, make sure to smash the thumbs up. Let me know if you'd like to see how to specifically go viral on Instagram or how to specifically go viral on YouTube, and I can do these two videos to make it clear, like how to make the best thumbnail, how to make the best headline, because these things are all very important as well. Thanks so much for watching. Make sure to get my free Instagram ebook and hit the subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. I love you.